Ole Bull is maybe not so much directly remembered today as he was before, but at his own time he was incredibly famous. And the famous composer Robert Schumann wrote in his diary that today I had a visit from Ole Bull, and among all the violinists of today, he is the greatest one. We now play a piece by Ole Bull, which is written very much in the style of Schumann. So we hope you will enjoy this little Andante Cantabile. It's not in the program, but we added it. Piece by Ole Bull is from the program. It's called the Third Day's Sunday, or Seterjentens Søndag in Norwegian. And this was one of his most famous pieces, included in the Mountain Vision Suite. Some of you might have heard with orchestra with Arvid Hellefsen earlier this week or last week. And we do it now in an arrangement by Johan Svendsen, who was Norwegian, very famous conductor in Copenhagen, and also violinist himself. And he started off his career touring around Europe, among with this piece. And they said that he, especially the Frenchmen, liked this piece of music. It's a very beautiful melody again. Ole Bull said his main inspiration was the Italian opera singing for this type of music, as well as Norwegian folk music for other pieces. Thank you. Edvard Grieg was a young boy when he met Ole Bull the first time. And he describes this as a meeting with a half god. He was absolutely amazed by this man. And Ole Bull, who was a self-taught composer, very much through his life felt that he really didn't know exactly how to write for orchestra, and he didn't know the theory of composing. He composed anyway. But the generous type of person he was, when he understood that Edvard Grieg had a talent for composing, he convinced the parents of Edvard Grieg to send the young Edvard to Leipzig to study composition and get the education Ole Bull maybe would have wanted to have himself if he had had the chance. And we are extremely grateful for this in Norway, of course, because without this, maybe Edvard Grieg would never have become Edvard Grieg. Well, he would still have been Edvard Grieg, but then then nobody would know who that was. So incredibly important for the Norwegian culture and actually the whole Norwegian identity. We are going to start with the March from Sigurd Jorsalfar, which was one of the few pieces by Grieg he performed together with Ole Bull. So this is theater music, written to a play by, is it Bjørnson? I think so. But anyway, a rather short little march, but beautiful music. Thank you. Ole Bull, who was the great Norwegian inspiration who led to so much of our cultural life. He was on tour when he learned that his first wife had died, and this is when he wrote this very melancholic piece. This is in his own version for violin and piano from 1863. Ole Bull built this castle, Lysøen, towards the end of his life. And that brings us over to the last piece we are going to play before the break. And that would be part of his vision, which was indeed written the last year he lived as a birthday present to Longfellow, yes? Correct me if I say anything wrong. I was presented this score this morning. Actually, so we have taken a selection from this, and this was towards also towards the end of Longfellow's life, and both he and Ole Bull had birthdays in February, so they often celebrated it together. And the little selection we have chosen is almost like a funeral march. Maybe Ole Bull had the feeling it was soon going to be over. We play this incredible piece of music, and thank you for showing it to me. I did not know of its existence and did not know the music.